What's going on everyone, Jun with the Sushi Man here, and in this video I'll be showing how to make gunkanmaki. Gunkanmaki, or gunkan for short, is a style of sushi where there's a strip of seaweed wrapped around a ball of rice, and some sort of topping on it. If you've ever ordered ikura, tobiko, or uni, you've most likely seen it. And I'll be using ikura for my example today, but you're free to use whatever topping you like. I've seen everything from wagyu beef tartare to corn salad, so the possibilities are endless. And if you're finding my content helpful on your sushi making journey, definitely check out my book, How to Make Sushi at Home, a fundamental guide for beginners and beyond. It's packed with recipes and step-by-step instructions on basically everything sushi related. So whether you're an aspiring sushi chef or a home cook that wants to start learning how to make sushi, this book is for you. I'll leave links in the description below for those that are interested. And I also want to take this time to thank you all. Whether you've subscribed, following, liked, or just browsing my videos, thanks for being here. Hitting that like and subscribe button does really help, so again, appreciate your support, and I hope to bring you much more content in the near future. Alright, let's get right into it. Now, if you've seen my other videos, you probably already know, but I'd like to start off with a little bit of background and history of the sushi we're making. There's so much history and culture behind sushi that it's a waste not to talk about it, at least a little bit. So why is it called gunkanmaki? Well, the word gunkan means battleship or warship in Japanese, and the oval boat-like shape that these little guys have reminded people of exactly that, a ship. The maki part means to roll or to wrap, which represents a seaweed wrapped around it. This style of sushi was created back in the early 1940s, and it became extremely popular in Japan. It allows chefs to use loose ingredients that they normally wouldn't be able to make into bite-sized sushi form. So things like ikura, tobiko, any type of roe really, or something with a slick texture like raw oysters or quail eggs. It also made it easier to use scrapings or parts of fish that were too small and make it into something like negitoro or negihama, which are both awesome gunkan toppings. And this makes it super fun because you can practically put whatever you want on there. Alright, that's it for the gunkanmaki history lesson. Let's move on. So first we'll go over the tools and supplies. We're going to need a cutting board or a clean working surface. A sharp knife. I'll be using my go-to sushi knife here, which is a Masamoto VG series Sujihiki. A bowl of cold water or tezu. A clean damp kitchen towel. A spoon, depending on what type of topping. And then some sort of serving plate. And that's about it. Pretty simple. Now let's move on to the ingredients. Ingredients are going to depend on what type of topping obviously, but we'll definitely need some sushi rice and some nori. These are half sheets. I'm going to be using some ikura, which is salmon roe, but again, regardless of the topping you use, the actual process of making gunkan will be the same. Just make sure to have all the toppings ready before you start. Also, if you want to add any garnishes, then have those ready as well. I have a few slices of cucumber here which I'm going to add with the ikura. And this is super simple, it's just part of an English cucumber cut in half and then cut into these thin semicircle slices. And lastly we have some wasabi and ginger. And soy sauce of course if you like. Alright, now let's get into making our gunkanmaki. Step 1 is to cut our nori sheet into the right size. So there's a couple ways you can do this. First way is just taking this whole thing and cutting it into thirds the long way. So basically you have 3 long strips. This works, but the nori tends to be just a tad bit too long. Not the end of the world, and you could just wrap it around the rice some more. However, this second method will give you a cleaner finish. So with this second method, we first cut 2 small strips crosswise, roughly about 3/8 of an inch wide, or about 1 centimeter. We call these smaller strips obi, which means belt, and it's used for certain nigirizushi to hold the neta or topping in place. Unagi, tamago, and taco are some good examples. Next, we cut this big sheet into 3 even strips lengthwise. This ends up being the perfect length for the correct size gunkanmaki. Now, if you're not planning on making any nigirizushi using the obi, then it becomes a bit of a waste. I mean, you can always just eat it as a snack, but if you're not planning on using it or eating it at all, then you probably want to stick to the first method. Alright, now that we have our strips of nori cut, it's time to make our shari-dama, or rice ball. First, wet both hands by dipping it into the water. Spread it all around so that your palms are wet and shiny, but not dripping. Grab some rice and gently form it into a ball, about the size of a ping pong ball. Try to keep it as fluffy as possible and avoid squeezing it too tight. From here, technically you want to follow the same motions as when making nigirizushi, just without the fish. But this can get pretty complicated and honestly it's not very beginner friendly. Now if you do want to learn these steps, check out my how to make nigirizushi video and follow the step-by-step instructions there. However, for this tutorial, I'm going to keep it much more simple so that you're not overwhelmed with this process. So that said, after you make the small rice ball, basically just shape it into a small log form using your fingers and your palm. Remember Play-Doh? Now how you do this is up to you, but the important part is to apply even and light pressure so that the rice doesn't get too compact. And you don't have to worry too much about the shape being perfect either, since the seaweed is going to wrap around it. And also, make all the rice balls first before we move on to the next step. I'm only going to be making two for this video, so I'm ready to go. Alright, after you're done sculpting your masterpiece, lay it on the cutting board horizontally, one at a time. In this part, you want your hands to be dry so that the nori doesn't get soggy. So just use a paper towel or something to make sure your fingers aren't wet. Now we take one strip of nori that we cut earlier, and starting from the far side, we wrap it around the rice. And you want the rough side of the nori to be the one touching the rice. Also make sure that the nori is parallel and touching the cutting board as you do this. So start with the rice in the center of the strip, and wrap it around completely so that the seaweed wraps around on itself. If you need, you can use a grain of rice as glue to seal the overlap part together. Now press down gently on the rice from the top so that there's a slight pocket, and I mean very slight. This will help the topping stay on there properly. Now do this for however many gunkans you're making, and then move on to the toppings. Alright, now that we have the base of the gunkan ready, we can start topping it. So in my case, I'm going to just spoon this ikura onto the rice and inside the nori. And I almost forgot. Let me lay some of these cucumber slices in there first though, since it complements the ikura nicely. And now we just put a spoonful of this right on top onto each piece. And boom, there you go. Now you officially know how to make gunkanmaki. And remember, you want to move fast with this since the nori will start to absorb the moisture and lose its crispiness. Now I'm just going to plate this real quick. Add some wasabi and ginger on the side. And there you go. Alright, that's it from me, and let me know in the comments what your favorite gunkanmaki topping is. Or if you made something out of the ordinary that turned out amazing. Or really bad. As always, thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button if you found this video helpful. See you on the next one. Arigatou gozaimasu.